EigenLayer recently surpassed $7 billion in deposits. It's one of the most hyped crypto narratives, and the product isn't even fully out. What is restaking, and why is it important? In this video, I want to explain EigenLayer as simply as possible so anyone can understand, even if you're new to blockchain. Finally, I'll break down how you can participate in the future of EigenLayer. Before we get to restaking, let's talk about staking. Previously, Ethereum used proof of work, which relied on computing power to secure the network. But somewhat recently, Ethereum upgraded to proof of stake. In this system, validators stake ETH to verify transactions. When you verify correctly, you earn more ETH. But if you don't, either as a mistake or maliciously, you have your stake slashed as a punishment. Staking is built on the premise that people are rational. They want to make money and don't want to lose money. As a result of this switch, Ethereum massively reduced its energy consumption, and it no longer had to pay these miners, which made the economic model of ETH much more efficient. Most importantly, this came without sacrificing security. An attacker would need to control one-third of the staked ETH, which is an impossible amount of money. With these benefits, proof of stake became the prevailing consensus mechanism for most infrastructure projects. Let's say I wanted to make a decentralized subscriber count oracle on the blockchain, but not just anyone can submit a number. You first have to stake some money. Then, if your proposed count is accepted by other stakers, I pay you a reward. But if you give an unpopular number, you lose your money as a punishment. As long as over two-thirds of the stake is controlled by honest actors, we can ensure my subscriber count is accurately and securely updated on the blockchain. But this seems pretty inefficient. First, it's hard to find people who want to stake and run my software. Staking also means missing out on other money-making opportunities, like Ethereum's 3% yield. Finally, the system isn't that secure. If I cannot attract a large staker set, it's easy for someone to take over the majority stake. Let's say there's a bet on my subscriber count. Clearly this should resolve to no, but a malicious actor could bet yes and manipulate my oracle. Even if his stake eventually gets slashed, he won more money than he lost. The value securing my oracle was not enough for the value secured by my oracle. If this application relies on these three services and my oracle fails, the entire application fails. The cost to corrupt any application is simply the cost needed to compromise its weakest infrastructural dependency. This is inefficient fractured trust, where stakers can only stake in one service and lose out on the other yield. But what if there was a more consolidated hub for staking? EigenLayer aims to solve this through the concept of restaking. Basically, you stake your ETH, then you stake it again and again. So here's the core of EigenLayer. You, the user, first stake to earn the base 3% yield for securing Ethereum. Then you can choose other commitments to participate in using the same stake. Run their software, and earn their rewards, but act wrongly in any of them and get slashed. Each one of these is called an actively validated service. These are written by developers like me who want to hire stakers to secure a service. So I get to decide parameters like the reward mechanism and slashing conditions. This one is pretty important. Stakers will want to read the fine print because they could potentially lose all their money. Depending on the risk and reward of an AVS, the free market will determine how many stakers participate. I also get to decide something called an unbonding period. This is to prevent you from, let's say, lying about my subscriber counts, then quickly unstaking your money before you get slashed. After you unstake, you have to wait this unbonding period before you can finally withdraw. If you are part of multiple AVSs, your unbonding period is set to the longest one. This is basically all EigenLayer is. It's a platform to connect stakers and infrastructure developers. Stakers offer economic security while earning additional rewards with their capital. Through restaking, EigenLayer pools security and makes it easy for developers to utilize this network of trust. We've already seen one application that could be built on EigenLayer. This can be extended into any oracle, like the price of ETH. Here are some other things that are possible on EigenLayer. Think of this like Google Drive. Each staker has a hard drive and gets paid to store data. This is especially useful for rollups. Basically, rollups make it cheaper to transact on Ethereum by rolling up bundles of transactions. They need a place to store this data, but only need it for around a week. EigenLayer enables a high-rate, low-cost data availability layer. These rollups also need to process transactions. Currently, this is done through a centralized sequencer who listens to transactions and puts them in order. but EigenLayer can be used to decentralize this, ensuring a more fair and censorship-resistant process. If you want to move your money from a chain like Arbitrum to Ethereum, it takes 7 days to process, because this is the challenge period where any observer can challenge the validity of your transaction. Only then, if nobody challenges it after 7 days, does your transaction go through. These bridges can be optimized through EigenLayer, allowing for stakers to directly verify transactions, making it a lot faster. The truth is that most users are lazy. They have money but don't want to run the actual software. It's complicated, expensive, and oops, my internet went down and I lost all my ETH. There are protocols that will do this hard work for you. You may have already seen this in something like Coinbase, where staking your ETH is as easy as clicking a button. You give them your ETH, they stake it, and they give back this token called a liquid staking token. So now we have staked. Let's go a step further and restake. EigenLayer then lets you delegate this to AVS operators. An operator is someone running the AVS and says, hey, point your capital to me. I'll generate the rewards for you in exchange for a small fee. Of course, you have to trust this delegator because they control and you get slashed. This is out of scope of the EigenLayer protocol, and it's up to users to choose operators they trust. Remember, more AVSs means more yield, but also more risk. So let's recap. You could stake ETH yourself and run the AVSs yourself, but EigenLayer makes it much easier for the average user by allowing liquid staking tokens for staking and delegation for restaking. You, the user, earn yield by delegating your money to trusted operators. Operators run the tasks and take a portion as a fee. Developers create these services and supply the rewards. Remember that all the applications I talked about are not out yet. These are just ideas, and anyone can make their own. This is the beauty of EigenLayer. I think EigenLayer is one of the most important innovations for Ethereum, and I'm excited to see what's possible.